Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about Docker and how to Dockerize your Maven Java application. So let's start by creating a Maven application. We do that by typing Maven archetype generate. And this will actually, you can give this a lot of different parameters, so you can say what it should do, but you can also run this in an interactive mode where you tell it which kind of archetype you want to use and what your group ID, archetype ID should be, and so on. First off, it asks you for an archetype ID or a type, and in my case, I use the standard, which is the quick start archetype, and 1.1 is fine. We give it a group ID, org EI. We can have an artifact ID of the service. We can say Docker service. And 1.1 snapshot package could be org EI. Service, and let's say that that's correct. Then we will get a Docker service directory, and in this directory you have a POM file and a source. And if we want to build this, and we actually type Maven package, this will actually not build, because this is an archetype that doesn't have support for the correct compiler. So it uses the standard compiler for Maven, and in this case that's 1.5, which is no longer supported. So we will go into our POM file, and in the properties here we will add the Maven compiler source property, and that we will set to 1.8 Maven compiler source, and then we will also set the Maven compiler target, that should also be 1.8. So if we package this one, I believe it will actually package and run the test. And this test is nothing to write home about, it's just very simple, check that equal is true or something. So let's open Atom on our source file and make this first application a little bit more interesting. So when Atom starts here in a little while, come on, there we have it, source file application. So let's start by creating a public static void sleep function. It will take some nanos, and we will try thread sleep for nanos, and we will catch exception e print stack trace. That's just so we have something that can sleep for a while. We will import the java.lang.exception, so we have that package, and then we will have some more interesting text here. So let's type up, and let's do a sleep for 400, and then we do that, let's say, 4 times, and then we have this is lost staying alive, so we actually know that our service is living. And we will do some prints after this. Let's say that we do 5 of those, and we have a last sleep of a second. So So let's go back to our terminal here, and if we package this up, and when the tests have run, or the one test, we can actually run this package. So we will run target, and this is Docker service snapshot jar, and then we have arg ea service app. Now this will run the service and say staying alive. And just so it stays alive a little bit longer, we can add a while loop here as well. While true, and let's do this little loop here. So that could be fun. And now we want to dockerize this very important service that we have created. And in order to do that, we need to create a Docker file. So let's atom docker file, and then we will get a new atom with this Docker file. Save that there, and in the Docker file we need to add a from. From is the actual package that this should start from. So usually you have some kind of image that you start from. It could be an Ubuntu image or any other distribution if you like that. I use a little bit more sophisticated one, which comes from SGREIO, and it's Java Oracle. So it will actually give me the Oracle binary, so I can run Java jobs directly. And then we have a maintainer, and that could be, let's say, me. And we have my email at gmail.com. So now everybody knows that I have created this package. We need to run app get update. We need to run apt get install dash y, so don't ask any questions. Maven, so we have actually Maven on our computer. Then we need to copy our source files. In this file we need the POM file, and I want to put that in USR local service / pom.xml, and we also need to copy the source directory. So again, user local service source. So we have copied all those files. Then I want to set the work directory, so if we actually run the next set of commands in that directory. So usr local service. And then there I need to run Maven package. So run is a command that actually runs during the build process. So all the commands I have written so far is actually to build my Docker image. So when we have built our Docker image, we have packaged it up, so we have everything ready to run, we can do the last command. And the difference between run and command is that command is running when you start the image. So when the image is started, it will run this command. And in this case, you type out each and every of the parts of the command in different parts of a list. So we have a list of command arguments. So here we have Java. The next argument is class path. Then we put this target / docker service is 1.0- snapshot jar. And the last part, we put our yay service app. So that's the command we want to run when everything is done. So now we have a Docker file, and in order, we go back to our command line. In order to run this, we do docker build -t, so we will give it an actual name, And in this case, we call it my image, and it should be the latest version of that. And let's see here. I wonder if I Docker build requires exactly one argument. Let's see, we need also the Docker service to be running. Haven't started that today. Let's start it up. And then we actually need to say dot in the end here. So we give it a target a name, my image version latest. And then I need to put a dot in the end. So I say this current directory, look there for my Docker image. So this will actually start running here. It will fetch all the packages from the Ubuntu repository. So it actually does an ATP get update, so it will refresh all of that, and it will do the installation of Maven and so on, everything that we have said in our Docker file. So I will cut it here, and we will get back when it actually are done with this build. Welcome back, and now we have built our Docker image. As you see here, the last command that was run was actually this adding this command Java target application thing. And the last thing that actually ran was the Maven build process that did this last build. So we in our service directory, we have a target Docker service 1.0 snapshot. And I think this command looks right, so it should just be that we can run this. So we run Docker, so we do sudo run Docker, and then we use the run command, so we actually run the image IT for interactive, and create the TTY. And then we do my image, so we will run this image, and if I can spell it, so it does staying alive, so it will actually run this over and over again because we have while true. So this was what I wanted to go through today. Today we have talked about how to generate something with Maven. So we generate a very simple archetype. Then we built this very simple Java program that just types out a message every second. And then we Dockerize this by creating a Docker file. We added the from tags. We told it what's start image to work from. We added a maintainer. We added some run steps to actually create the different parts that needed to run in our Docker file to build it up and work with it. We added a workspace and copied some file over to our Docker file. And then we set a command that were actually run when this Docker file was executed. So this, I hope you learned something from this today. I hope that Docker is a little bit more understandable and not that frightening to use in your toolbox. And if you have any suggestions on to improve this Docker image, please tell me. I'm currently looking at setting up some Docker images for different services. So I'm trying to figure out the best way to set up some Docker images and create good images. If you haven't subscribed yet, do that. Share this with your friends and your colleagues. Give it a like if you thought it was good. And I really hope to see you in the next video.